The universe's days are numbered unless the physics drives it fundamentally differs from what we presently understand. Everything in the universe, including our planet, will pass away at some point. Our planet will start to die after a few billion years, providing a cataclysmic event does not occur before. This process will start when our sun dies one day, which is an awesome event. One popular subject of prediction is the fate of the Earth and other planets in our solar system when the sun becomes a red giant. We live off the radiation our sun emits at this white dwarf stage. What happens as it enters the red giant phase? How much time do we have left? Stay till the end of this video to find out. People have recognized the importance of the sun to life as we know it since the dawn of recorded human history. This is evidenced by its significance of it to numerous mythical and cosmological systems all across the world. However, as our understanding deepened, we realized that the sun existed long before us and would continue to exist when we were gone. Our sun began its life about 40 million years before our Earth had formed, having originated about 4.6 billion years ago. Hence, the sun will expand even after the Earth is no longer there. The sun will have 256 times its current size when it's fully developed red giant, which will happen in about 7.59 billion years. In this video, we will explore the birth of the sun, its evolution, and what will happen with Earth in a trillion years when the sun grows into a red giant. Please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel for more stuff before we continue. Click the bell icon to sign up for new video alerts. Have you already executed it? Let's move on. The sun will run out of hydrogen fuel in its core in about 5 billion years and begin burning helium instead, prompting a red giant star transformation. Its atmosphere will enlarge during this transition to a distance of around 1 astronomical unit, which is the present mean Earth-Sun distance. This implies that Mercury, Venus, and possibly Earth will be gradually engulfed by the sun. According to astronomer S. Alan Stern of the Southwest Research Institute, when the sun becomes a red giant, the temperature there will be similar to that of tropical areas on Earth now, including Miami Beach. The sun's creation. Nebular hypothesis, which holds that the sun and all the planets started as a massive cloud of molecular gas and dust billions of years ago, is the most widely accepted theory on how our sun and the solar system evolved. Then, some 4.57 billion years ago, this cloud underwent gravitational collapse at its core when anything from a passing star to a supernova shockwave initiated the process that resulted in the creation of our sun. In essence, this happened after pockets of dust and gas started to gather in denser areas. Due to momentum conservation, these zones started rotating as more and more matter was drawn into a while. Rising pressure drove them to heat up. Most of the material settled into a ball in the center, while the remainder was flattened into a sizable disk that encircled the ball. The planets would eventually be formed from the disk of material, while the ball at the center would eventually become the sun. After 100,000 years as a collapsing protostar, the sun underwent fusion ignition at its core due to inner pressure and temperature conditions. The sun was originally a T-Tauri star, a ferociously active star that emitted a powerful solar wind. Moreover, a few million years later, it finally took on its present shape. The progression of evolution of the sun. The sun will shine 10% brighter than it does now in 1.1 billion years. The Earth's atmosphere will absorb more heat energy due to the rise in brightness. This will start a greenhouse runaway effect akin to the one that made Venus into the awful hothouse it is today. The sun will be 40% brighter than it is presently in 3.5 billion years, resulting in the oceans boiling, the ice caps melting forever, and the loss of all atmospheric water vapor to space. The Earth will completely change into another hot, dry world, much like Venus, because life as we know it will be unable to live anywhere on the surface. The red giant phase. The sun will enter what is known as the red giant phase of its evolution in 5.4 billion years. When the core's hydrogen supply runs out, the inert helium ash accumulated there will become unstable and collapse under its own weight. This is when the process will start. The core will heat up and become denser, expanding the sun's size. It is predicted that the sun will eventually grow big enough to engulf Mercury, Venus, and even Earth's orbits. The immense heat of this red sun would roast our planet and make it impossible for life to survive, even if the Earth were to survive being eaten. However, when the sun enlarges, astronomers have noted that the planet's orbit is likely to shift as well. The sun will shed a huge amount of mass through strong stellar winds when it reaches this late stage in its evolution. As it expands, it loses mass, which sends the planet spiraling outward. The final hours of Earth. Eventually, Earth will be engulfed by the sun. The future seems promising, even unrealistic. Over the next few billion years, as the sun gradually brightens and expands, it will desiccate the Earth, making it hot, brown, and uninhabitable. The sun will grow to its largest size as a red giant in around 7.6 billion years, when its surface will be 20% larger than Earth's orbit today and shine 3,000 times brighter. The sun will eventually disintegrate into a white dwarf. Scientists agree on the future of the sun, but they disagree on the future of Earth. Numerous scientists have come to conflicting findings since 1924, when British mathematician James Jeans first thought about Earth's future during the sun's red giant phase. Our planet can sometimes avoid vaporization, but according to the most recent research, it cannot. Schroeder and Smith contend that the Earth will not endure the sun's expansion. The Earth will not have the opportunity to expand to an orbit that is 1.5 AUs beyond its current orbit, which is 50% farther. The expanding sun will engulf just before the Earth reaches the apex of the red giant phase. The sun still has 0.25 AU and 500,000 years to grow. The Earth and gas particles will collide once inside the sun's atmosphere. It will drift inward as its orbit decays. At 1.15 AU, the Earth's current distance from the sun could endure the expansion phase. We would also be successful if we could push our planet to its distance. However, at this time, such a discussion is purely theoretical and falls under science fiction. The habitable zone of our sun, as we know it, will have vanished long before it approaches its red giant phase. According to astronomers, this zone will extend past the Earth's orbit in around a billion years. The Earth's seas will evaporate due to the sun's heating, and the hydrogen in the water will subsequently be blasted away by solar radiation. Oceans will never exist on Earth again, and eventually they will melt. The estimated effects of several long-term variables can be used to protect Earth's biological and geological future. The chemistry on Earth's surface, the rate at which the planet's interior is cooling, the gravitational interactions with other solar system bodies, and a constant rise in the sun's luminosity are a few of these. The extensive influence of human-made technology, such as climate engineering, which may have a huge impact on the globe, is a variable. For instance, technology is to blame for the current Holocene extinction, the repercussions of which could continue up to 5 million years. The extinction of humanity due to technology may cause the Earth to eventually return to a slower evolutionary speed driven only by long-term natural processes. A 10% increase in sun luminosity in 1 billion years will turn the atmosphere into a wet greenhouse and cause the seas to evaporate uncontrollably. The planet's magnetic dynamo may stop operating in 2 to 3 billion years, causing the magnetosphere to deteriorate and accelerating the loss of volatiles from the outer atmosphere. In 4 billion years, the rise in the Earth's surface temperature will set off a runaway greenhouse effect that will produce conditions that are more extreme than those on Venus now and heat the planet's surface to the point of melting. All life on Earth will have vanished by then. Finally, the most likely outcome for the planet is its absorption by the sun in roughly 7.5 billion years, once the star has grown past the planet's present orbit and entered the red giant phase. Today's video has come to an end. If you like this video, subscribe to the channel and give it a thumbs up. Remember to click the bell icon to get alerts when new videos are posted. I will see you in the upcoming video. Bye for now.